Good afternoon and warm greetings to all invited guests, dignitaries, participants, colleagues and friends. On behalf of Kandalu Shala, an institution dedicated for higher learning and research in ancient wisdom, welcomes you all to the National Lecture Series on Wheels. Today we have with us a promising Vedic scholar, Dr. K. A. Ravindran, Professor of Sahitya and Coordinator of Center for Vedic Studies, Sri Sankaracharya University of Sanskrit, to deliver the fifth edition of Wheels lecture series. We are very glad to welcome the master of ceremony for today's session, and young Vedic scholar, Dr. Ajithan, who is the faculty of our Kandalu Shala. Over to Dr. Ajithan.
Let us start with an invocation. I invite Dr. Sarita Maheshwaran for invocation.
Sada balarupapi vighnadrihantrim mahadandivatrapi panchasyamanyam sada balarupapi vighnadrihantrim mahadantivatrapi panchasyamanyam vidhindradimrugya ganeshabhidhame vidhatram shriyam kapi kalyana murti vidhattam shriyam kapi kalyana murti.
Thank you, Sarita ma'am, for beautiful rendition of Benedictory verses. Good afternoon to all. I am so happy and privileged to welcome you all to the National Lecture Series on Vedic Epistemology and Exegesis. As you probably know, this is the fifth lecture in the lecture series organized by Kandalu Shala, an institute for higher learning and research in ancient Indian wisdom. Today, we have with us Dr. K. A. Ravindran, Professor of Sahitya, Sri Sankaracharya University of Sanskrit, Kaladi, my teacher, and also author of a couple of books, namely Samaveda Darpanam Artham Bharatiya Siddhantangal. He has been teaching for 23 years now, and at present he is working on several projects like editing Kriyasara, a work on Kerala Tantra, and its two unpublished commentaries. He is such an academician who works tirelessly to propagate the knowledge of Veda through some of his scholarly articles and editing and publishing some unpublished manuscripts. We are lucky today to have him with us to speak on the topic Vedic Exegesis, Kerala's contribution. As you may know, Kerala's contribution to Vedic literature is immense, which include commentaries on Vedic literature, namely Vedas, Brahmanas, Shikshas, Pradishakhyas, Anukramanis, etc. To this vast corpus of literature, the contributions of scholars like Matridatta, Bhavatrata, Udaya, Narayana, Nilakantha Yogiyar, Shadguru Shishya, Payur Parameshwara, Godavarma deserves special mention. Let us wait for his speech to know much about the contributions of these men of letters. On behalf of Kandalu Shala and scholars who gathered here online, I welcome Professor K. A. Ravindran to this lecture series. Welcome to you, sir. Professor Murali Madhavan, Director in Chief, Kandalu Shala, and a mastermind behind all academic endeavors envisioned and executed by this institute, will be presiding over the function. So let me welcome Murali Madhavan, sir, to this academic event and subsequently to chair the lecture. Welcome to you, sir. I also welcome Dr. V. Nirmala, who is going to present the citation to today's speaker, and Dr. Shamsir PC, who will be proposing vote of thanks. Welcome to both of you. This is a serious academic event which needs not only an able speaker but also enthusiastic listeners. veteran scholars like Professor K.T. Madhavan sir, Dr. R. Thyagarajan, etc., and many other scholars constitute our audience. Let me welcome all who gathered here online to grace the occasion. Welcome to you all. Thank you. So let us move on to the next topic. Next is the presidential address. I invite Professor Murali Madhavan sir for his presidential address.
Shruti Smriti Purananam Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Pada Sangaram Loka Sangaram Yonda Pravishya Mama Vajamimam Prasuptam Sanjeevayatyakhila Shakridhara Swathamna Anyamsa Hastajarana Shravanatvagadin Pranan Namo Bhagavate Purushaya Tubhyam. Today's chief guest, the main speaker, my good old friend Dr. K. Ravindran, who is a professor in Shankaracharya University, who was my colleague for several decades. Dr. Sarida Maheshwaran, Dr. Ajithan, Dr. Nirmala, Dr. P.C. Shamsir, Dr. Pradeep Jodi, learned professors Dr. K.T. Madhavan and Professor R. Thyagarajan, other learned participants present in the Kandroor Shala platform today. I welcome you all to this learned assembly, August assembly of scholars, to listen the talk of Dr. K.A. Ravindran. Today I have to give my presidential address mainly based on the Vedic exegesis of Kerala. The contribution of Kerala to Vedic exegesis is immense in volume and importance. Scholars from Kerala have written several exegetical works on Vedic texts. They have also preserved intact the oral tradition for thousands of years. Here, the tradition in Kerala, the tradition is authentic and alive, and is not the result of recent revivals. In the apparently isolated corner of southwest India, a few orthodox Nambudiri Brahmana families have maintained their Vedic tradition with meticulous care, preserving it from generation to generation. Two of the ancient Vedic rituals, the Agnishtoma, which lasts for 5 days, and the Agnichayana, or Adhiratra, which lasts for 12 days, was happening regularly. During the last 100 years, Adhiratra has been performed more than 50 times and Agnishtoma more than 125 times. It is a rough calculation. One who has performed an Agnishtoma is called Somayaji or Chomadiri in Malayalam, and one who has performed an Adhiratra is called Akitiri. The Agnichayana performed at Panyal in 1975 with international cooperation, and the two volumes of its proceedings and studies edited by the learned Vedic scholar Professor Fritz Stahl have brought to light much information about Kerala tradition regarding Vedic studies and exegesis. Some decades back, Adhiratra was performed at Pundur with much publicity and attracted Vedic scholars from different parts of India and abroad. Leading newspapers in Kerala wrote long articles on the daily procedure, and there were discussions. It may be hoped that the tradition has been saved from extinction. the Aitareya and Kaushitaki Shakhas of the Rig Veda have been preserved and kept alive in Kerala. The Kaushitakins are in minority and are now available only in Kerala, Gujarat, and to a limited extent in Maharashtra. The Aitareyans follow the Shravada Sutra of Ashwalayana and the Kaushitakins thereof Sankhayana. The Kaushitakins are called Sankhayanas in Gujarat and Maharashtra, but solely by the name of Kaushitakins in Kerala. The Jaimaniya Shakha of Samaveda is preserved only in a few families in Kerala and Tamil Nadu. The Jaimaniya Brahmana is probably the earliest Brahmana. One complete manuscript was discovered by E.R. Srikrishna Sharma from Kodundarepalli near Palakkad and was that the source of Raghuveera Lokesh Chandra edition in 1954. Three or four manuscripts were later discovered by Asko Parpola from Finland, Helsinki, and E.R. Srikrishna Sharma from Nellikatta Akkithiripaal at Panyar. And Sharma has prepared a critical edition with the translation of Brahmana for Indira Gandhi National Center for Arts in Delhi. The Nambudiri Brahmanas of Kerala began to specialize in Vedic studies and Vedic exegesis from very early times. In the 7th century Christian era, Dendin refers in his Avanti Sundari Katha to two scholars from Kerala as his friends. Madhurdatta, a poet who also wrote some commentaries, and his father Bhavatrata, commentator of Kalpasutras. This Bhavatrata is probably identical with the author of the commentary on Jaimaniya Shravada Sutra. Shadguru Shishya, who flourished in Kerala during the 12th century, has written several commentaries on Vedic texts, Sukhaprada on the Aitareya Brahmana, Mokshaprada on the Aitareya Aranyaka, Abhayaprada on the Ashulayana Shravada Sutra, and Vedartha Deepika on the Sarvanukramani of Shaunaka. He refers to some Malayalam Tadhavas of Sanskrit words like Changata for Samhita, Kirihiyam for Grihyam, and Takkana for Dikshina. This scholar calls himself Shadguru Shishya, since he considers six deities as his preceptors. His real name is not known. This commentary is published by Ramlal Kapoor Trust, Sonepat, from Haryana, 1985. Another scholar commentator of Vedic texts is Udaya of Muriyamangalam family of Brahmakalam, not far from Guruvayur, very near to my own ancestral house. I have seen that old house even now. It is Brahmakulam. In Sanskrit, it is called Brahmakalam. It is not far from Guruvayur. He was the son of Narayana Yajwan and Savitri. He wrote the Sughada commentary on the Kaushitaki Brahmana of the Rigveda, which is not only an excellent piece of textual exegesis, but also a lucid exposition of the ritual application. It shows Udaya's intimate knowledge of the rituals dealt with in the Brahmana text. His father has performed a Jyotishtoma Yaga, as the epithet the Yajwan suggests. Professor E.R. Srikrishna Sharma edited and published from Germany, from Heidelberg, the Kerala recension of Kaushitaki Brahmana and the Sukhada commentary of Udaya. Nirupta he used all available manuscripts. E.R. Srikrishna Sharma used all available manuscripts, including the one in the Adyar library, which has been noticed by Professor C. Kunyan Raja. He also got a manuscript from the late Erkara Raman Nambudiri, a great Rigvedic scholar, he also got advice and help from Erkara Ramanambuthi. According to Sharma, there is a tradition making Udaya a nephew of Rishi, probably of the Payur Bhatta family, flourished in the 15th century. Katyayana's Rigveda Sarvanukramani, well-known general index, has been very popular in Kerala. It is Sadguru Shishya's commentary was partly published from Oxford by MacDonald. Narayana of Akkitham family of Vanganad near Tripunitra has written the Viva Prabha commentary on it. Narayana was the son of Arya and belonged to Angirasa Kula. He wrote Viva Prabha commentaries on Kayada's Bhashya Pradipa and on the Vararuja Sangraha, which is an anthology of Rigvedic stanzas generally used in daily rituals like Sandhyavandana. His family name Akkitham shows that there were many ancestors in that family who performed Agni Chayana. Kerala has produced another elaborate commentary on Sarvanukramanika. It is called Sarvanukramani Padya Vivruti. The author is from Kerala, but his name is not known. As the title indicates, it is written in verse form, Padya Vivruti. A rare copy of this manuscript belongs to C. Kunjan Raja, later handed out to Dr. K. Kunjan Raja. And this manuscript is with me now and ready for any kind of study. Dr. Parameshwara Ital has edited this work from Heidelberg University in Germany. Another manuscript originally belonged to Erkara Ramanambudri was with Dr. E.R. Shirisha Sharma. Nilakandha Yogiyar of Thaikattu Vaidika family, who was alive during the 16th century, wrote the Shravuta Prayashchitta Sangraha on Shravuta expiatory rites. Another very important Kerala work on Vedic exegesis is Nirukta Vartika, an elaborate metrical commentary on Yaska's Nirukta. Its author became a sannyasin, taking the name Padmapada Acharya. Before taking to sannyasa, he was Nilakandha, belonging to a Brahmana family at Kondayur on the banks of Bharatapura. It is very near Deshamangalam and that place. Nila. He belonged to the Yajurveda and to the Gargya Gotra. His father was Krishna Sharma, who was well versed in Yajna performance. All these informations about his biodata is being given. It is an exception that rarely we come across the biodata given by the author himself in his own book. Jamadagniena Ramena Gargyaya Pratipadide Koshthayur Kondayur, that is Koshthayur. Koshthayur idi vikhyade Grame Kerala Pujide Brahmananam Sahasrena Jushtaye Shishta Janarchide Yatnigaihi Vedavidhishta Sarve Devobashokide Avyavachinna Yajnanam Yajurveda Kula Veda Vidam Kule Kule Mahadi Gargyanam Nilakandhopyajayata Kira Sharma Pidayasya Yajwa Yajna Vishwara Vishardaha Bahu Yajvi Chaturvedo Rudra Sharma Pitamaha. It goes like that. It is a very long description, but he has given the complete picture of his family. On the basis of the copy of manuscript got from Kerala, probably from the Government Sanskrit College Tripunitra, by Professor C. Kunjan Raja, he published a paper on Nirukta Vartika in the Adayar Library Bulletin. Later, the work has been published by Ramlal Kapoor Trust, edited by Dr. Vijayapal in 1982 on the basis of this paper manuscript from Tripunitra. Recently, I found the exemplar of this manuscript in Tripunitra Science College. Recently, some 2 years back. The 6 verses quoted by Payur Parameshwara in Gopaliga commentary on Mandara Mishra's Spoda Siddhi are actually found in Nirukta Vartika, in Nirukta's work that Nilakandha's work, Nirupta Vartika. I'm skipping some areas. Since Payur Parameshwara, commentator on this Kodasiddhi, quotes Nirupta Vartika as an authority, its author cannot be later than the 14th century. Keralur Nilakandha Somayaji has also quoted from the Nirupta Vartika. In his Hashya on Aryabhadiya, it is also referred to in the anonymous Sarvanukramani Padya Vivruti. Nirupta Vartika is an excellent commentary which is sure to help in furthering Vedic exegesis. Melpathur Narayana Bhatta wrote a small poem in 9 verses, the Sukha Shloka, which is apparently a stotra in praise of the goddess, but which gives statistical details relating to the Ashtaka and Adhyaya, that Varga classification of the Rigveda. Using the Katapayadi notation, he has done this. This has been edited by C. Kunjan Raja earlier. Godavarma Yuvaraja of Kodungallur, who is Vidya Divaraja, known as Vidya Divaraja of Kodungallur in 1800, wrote a Garuda Chayana Pramana on the construction of the Vedi of the Garuda Chaya. So besides these, there are several Malayalam works which deals with the ritual exegesis. For example, the Charumukil Pacha by Charumukha Parameshwaran Nambudiri. The procedures for the various rituals are described in Malayalam works called Chadanga, Chadanga Pustakam. There were the popular texts used by the Nambudirins. These were the popular texts used by Nambudirins as handbooks to keep them in the performing of rituals. And Sri Narayana Mangalatha Ravindran Nambudiri, rather known as Ittirevi Nambudiri, who is our member of Kandarur Shala, still alive, a great scholar in Rigvedic, is a direct student of Erkara Raman Nambudiri. He is one among few who is well versed in Kaushithaki Brahmana and its exposition. Coming to the modern period, we have to mention a few scholars. Erkara Raman Nambudiri, who is, as I told you earlier, and is a teacher of our Ittiri Naras Ittiri Nambudiri. Erkara Raman Nambudiri, who was an embodiment of the Kaushithaki tradition, his articles collected in Amanaya Madhanam were also translated in Sanskrit. He edited the Malayalam Mantri journal Anadi to popularize Vedic rituals. He took an active and decisive roles in the Panyala Dhiratram. Nillikattu Ittirevi, who was an authority on the Jaiminiya chanting, was also responsible for the preservation of the tradition of this Vedic Shaka. He was also a leading figure at the Panyal Adhiratram. V.K. Narayanan Bhattadri tried to stress the importance of studying the meaning of Vedic texts profusely on Vedic interpretation using Yaska and also Arabindu. Mahakavi Vallathol Narayana Menon also translated the Rigveda and prepared in his 70s, brought this ancient text to the ordinary people in Malayalam. OMC Nambudiripad published the Rigveda with his Malayalam translation and notes based on Sayana, which was a boon to the generally educated Malayalis to enter the heart of the Rigveda. The name of Sikunjan Raja deserves special mention in modern Vedic exegesis. He studied under MacDonald at Oxford and had discussion with the Goldener in Germany and Louis Renault in France. Though he was taught that Sayana was explaining the Vedas without any traditional basis and modern research methodology using comparative and historical approaches is found to help more than Sayana. Kunjan Raja, on his return from Europe, was able to get many pre-Sayana commentaries. And he proved and he established and he refuted all the theories of his teacher, MacDonald. And he established that the Sayana commentary, Sayana Bhashya, is with a solid base, and it is basing the pre-Bhashyas of Sayana. And several pre-Sayana Bhashya commentaries have been unearthed by C. Kunjan Raja on Vedic texts and published them for the first time. He was convinced that Sayana was using a continuous tradition, though a ritualistic tradition. Sayana's tradition is a ritualistic tradition, but it is a continuous tradition. So that is a solid base. Besides editing commentaries, he wrote several expository volumes like Vedas, A Cultural Study, Poet, Philosophers of the Rigveda, Quintessence of the Veda, etc. His edition of Asya Vamiya Sutta with Atmarama's Advaitic interpretation, together with the translation and notes explaining the riddles, is especially praiseworthy. As a successor in the field, the name of Dr. E.R. Shisha Sharma, I have mentioned several times earlier, has already been mentioned. K. Kunjan Raja also contributed several research articles on Vedic exegesis. So with some of such observations, some general observations on this, I never entered into the text. Dr. K. Ravindran, an expert in Vedic studies, he will be dwelling deep in the subject and giving more information regarding this. My humble work is only to introduce a general outline of Vedic exegesis that is being contributed by Kerala scholars. With this submission, I beg to remain. Thank you for your patient hearing. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for a wonderful speech. And it itself has been a small presentation. And what you have done is you have given a firm foundation to Ravindran sir to build upon. Thank you, sir, for your wonderful presidential address. And next is the main item of today's program. I invite Professor K. Ravindran for delivering the lecture. As you know, he is going to speak on Vedic exegesis, Kerala's contribution. So over to you, sir.
Sadashivasamarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Parambaram. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, we are audible.
Yeah. Respected Professor Dr. P.C. Murali Madhavan, my teacher. Vedabandhus, my other teachers, colleagues, students, and other scholars, a warm welcome and good afternoon to one and all. At the outset, I express sincere thanks to the authorities of Kandalur Sala for giving me an opportunity to speak something about the vast and varied contribution of Kerala towards Vedic studies and its dissemination in this Bills 2021. As Dr. Rajadhan said, Professor Murali Madhavan has made a good foundation to my lecture. Almost all the scholars that he mentioned is again coming in my paper also. He has made a general outlook or outline, and in my paper I am going to focus some deep thoughts regarding all these scholars, starting from Bhavatrada itself. Now I will go to my paper reading some points. Sorry to say that some points may be a repetition. that is normal, but I will manage the matter as far as I can. The land of Kerala has contributed succinctly and sufficiently strikingly in the field of Vedic studies. It's generally accepted that the Vedic culture was established here in the 6th and 7th centuries. There are several sound evidences to infer that deep thoughts on Vedic knowledge systems had acquired considerable basis in Kerala even by that time. Several Vedic learning centers were established here in the form of sabhamathas, salas, and yogams for teaching, learning, and practicing Vedas and Vedic topics. But some of these establishments could not resist the passage of time and accidents of history. As a result, many of them disappeared forever. Anyhow, some remnants survived the reverse situations, and they helped to retain the Vedic culture here. Recently, with the aid of those survived traces, the studies and researches on Vedas and Vedic studies are going on with more enthusiasm. Let me share my slides. Is it okay? Are you saying now? No.
No, no. Hello? Sir, you just click Kandalu Shala lecture. Only your screen is coming.
Okay.
Can you load it again?
Previously, yes, okay. Now, it's
okay. One minute. Let us see. Previously, it was available, and now it is.
Now I can see that, but what about the others? I don't know.
No, we can see only your screen, only your computer screen, only.
Only your video we can see.
Yes.
Now you. Can you do it again?
I will share. Yes. Okay. Now?
Yeah.
Yes.
It has come.
Yeah. Yes.
It is clear.
Okay. Thank you. In the beginning, I try to present before you that we can divide the whole period into two steps. And for convenience, I say the first period as up to 18,000 CE and 1,800, and the second period as 1,800 to 2021, the latest period. We can discuss the matters within these two periods. This, of course, there will be a medieval period, but for convenience, I am making only two periods. So the scholars of the first period, a few scholars, this is not a full list, a few scholars that we have won in the presidential address. Professor Murali Madhavan has referred to most of these in the presidential address. But I am going to some depth regarding these scholars. So I will read my paper now. First of all, is the Bhavarada or Bhavatrada. He's also referred to as Bhavarada in some cases, and Matradatta. The earliest references that we are getting with regard to the names of Kerala scholars in Vedic studies is from the writings of Acharya Dendin, an institution par excellence, lived in the 7th century AD. He has referred to the names of two great scholars from Kerala, Bhavarada, Athava Bhavatrada, and Matradatta, in his treatise called Avanti Sundari Katha. To quote, पित्रं च तवैष विश्वब्रह्मराशे कल्पसूत्र टीकाकारस्य सकल विद्यानदी पूरवादिधेः त्रयत्रिंशल् क्रदु विभूति भाविद क्रयत्रदेशस्य शापानुग्रह समर्थस्य ब्रह्मर्षेर भवरात नामना पुत्र तल्पुत्राणां तल्समान मेधादि संबदां द्वितीय तंद्रार्थ तत्व व्याख्यान चतुरश्चतुर्वेदविद् सर्वजन मातृभूत करुणावृत्तिर् मातृदत्त. दिस इज दि रेफरेंस. Professor Subramanya, Dr. S. Vendra Subramanya Iyer, in his book states that this Bhavatrada or Bhavarada is the commentator of Shravata Sutras and Grihya Sutras of Hiranyakeshin, and Madhradatta is the commentator of Grihya Sutras of Kaushitaki and Jaimini. Now, regarding Acharya Shankara, I'm not going to speak anything because he is very popular and all of us should know about him, his contributions. So I am not going to speak about him. Shadguru Shishya, the next one, is the author of, as Professor Murali Madhavan has said, the two Brahmanas of Rigveda, it is Aitareya and Kaushitaki, have been commented by Kerala scholars. The name of the commentary of Aitareya Brahmana is Sukhaprada, and the commentator is Shadguru Shishya, whose real name is unknown. It is supposed that the name Shadguru Shishya is a title with the meaning a student of six teachers. This is also is getting. Name of six teachers are given in a verse seen in the Sukhaprada Vritti of Shadguru Shishya, and it read like this: Vinayaka Sulabanir Mukundo Suryo Vyaso Shivayogi Diye Shat Tebhyo Nama Sapta Vidya Amrutasya Pradadrubhya Swashrita Valsalebhya. The verse gives a clear picture of six teachers who taught seven shastras to the disciple. It is also referred to at another instance that Vinayaka is the most affectionate teacher and he is the son of Parameshwara, the Lord. Vinayako Guru Priyo Giri Indra Jesha Nandana. Here it is to be assumed that among the six, Vinayaka and other four are the gods, and Sivayogi is the only one human being. In the beginning of Vyakhya to Sarvanukramani, it is given that the above mentioned six teachers made him fit for acquiring the meaning of Rigveda. Vinayaka Trisulanko Govinda Surya Evacha Vyasascha Sivayogi Di Sivayogi Cha Ye Shat Te Samayuyujan Rigveda Artha Amrata Aswade Bahu Swapna Nidarshanam. Date of Sadguru Shishya is taken as later half of 12th century AD. This opinion is based on the Kalivakya Khagotyanmeshupaya, seen in the verse at the end of Vedartha Deepika commentary written by Shadguru Shishya on Sarvanukramani of Katyayana. The Kalivakya mentioned above denotes the year 1178 AD. The use of Kalivakya for the denotation of life period is a common practice of Kerala writers. The known Kerala writers commonly use Chakabda or Vikramabda for this purpose. It is a valid ground to determine Shadguru Shishya as a Keralite. Moreover, Shadguru Shishya has used some Malayalam words such as Professor Murali Madhavan referred to, Changata for Samhita, Tavana, Mutal, Munpa, etc. at different places. All these factors point to the conclusion that Shadguru Shishya is a Keralite. The commentary of Shadguru Shishya is very elaborate and significant. Proper understanding of Paninian grammar is essential for studying this commentary. Dr. E.R. Sri Krishna Sharma opines that the Vedartha Deepika commentary is known by another name, Aitareya Brahmana Vedartha Prakasam. The commentary is by name Moksha Prada and Abhyudaya Prada on Aitareya Aranyaka and Ashwalayana Shravata Sutra respectively, also are written by Shadguru Shishya. Regarding the Sarvanukramani commentary, the words of praise made by Professor MacDonald in the preface of Sarvanukramani Vyakhya need special mention. He says his commentary on Sarvanukramani shows him to have been a man of some originality and of considerable learning, grammatical no less than Vedic. Sadhguru Shishya's commentary does not consist merely of a bare amplification explaining the obscurities rising from the brevity of the sutra style, but introduces many tales from Vedic mythology. But even when he relates these stories in his own works, he generally does so in shlokas. In fact, this commentator has a way of breaking into words even when speaking of far drier matters. He does not even shrink from working sutras of as of Panini into a poetical form. Now let me go to Udaya, the commentator of Kaushitaki Brahmana. Another Keralite scholar, Udaya of 16th century AD, is a commentator of Kaushitaki Brahmana. The name of the commentary is Sukhada or Sadartha Vimarshini. He belonged to the Miriamangalam family near Guruvayur, Thrissur district, Kerala. The commentary was first published from Germany in 1976 by Dr. E.R. Shri Krishna Sharma. In the preface to the edition, the editor gives the details of the manuscripts used by him for this edition. This edition was based on 8 manuscripts. They include both palm leaves and paper transcripts. They were available to the editor from different parts of Kerala. He obtained some manuscripts from Adyar Library and from the Madras Government Oriental Manuscript Library also. The commentary of Udaya is very elaborate, transparent, lucid, and clear. It is divided into 3 dashakas, each having 10 chapters. The commentary on 18th and 28th chapters is incomplete. Similarly, the commentary to the second khanda of 26th chapter also is not available. Besides, several gaps and lacunae of letters are seen in the manuscripts. The commentary on some of the chapters is fully in verse. In the beginning, there are 10 verses of general nature. These verses include benediction to various gods and the entire Vedic lore, salutation to teachers, to the great sage Kaushitaki, to the sage Suyajna, and finally to all who follow the path of those sages. Then he discloses his intention to write the commentary. The commentator follows a definite methodology which is kept throughout. While commenting the topic, he gives prominence to the credibility of the commentary. For it, he uses some techniques. The acceptance of a text mainly depends on the continuity and flow of description and its aesthetic beauty. If the text loses continuity, the reader will not be able to follow it. Udaya skillfully brings together the topics throughout the text so that the reader does not feel difficulty in following it. He gives a picture of the subject matter described in the preceding and succeeding chapters in a verse at the beginning of a new chapter. Then he describes the subject matter of each khanda and comments on important words and sacrificial concepts described in the basic text. Choosing to write in prose, mostly Udaya gives much care to incorporate verses at the beginning and at the end of each chapter, in addition to the routine ones. The proficiency of an author can be understood from this style of dealing the subject. Udaya shows great skill in this regard. While describing a particular topic, the commentator gives the etymologies of different difficult words so that the reader can easily know the reason for the usage of that particular word in the context. He amplifies the stories given briefly in the basic text and attaches several lokoktis or common sayings while explaining a particular ritual. This helps to understand the connection of that ritual with the ordinary life. This aspect is also appreciable that the commentary never becomes tougher than the original one. He incorporates some common maxims, Laukika Nyayas, to make the commentary more attractive. He uses prose and verse with equal ease, and some chapters are being commented in poetry only. Most commonly, he selects Anushtup meter in such contexts. Some beautiful verses in Shardulam Kridam, Shrakdhara, Malini, and Upajadi are also used. Thus, a variety of meters is seen throughout the text, which denotes his mastery in that topic and his aesthetic sensibility. While describing a topic, Udaya refers to the other treatises dealing with the similar subject matter and quotes from them to make his arguments more effective. He refers to Aitareya Brahmana and quotes from it at times. The other texts referred to by him are Mahabhashya, Mahabharata, Rigveda, other Samhitas, Nirukada, Taittiriya Brahmana, Upanishads like Brihadaranyaka, Chandogya, Taittiriya, and Maitri. The Nyayavartika Talpariya Tika, the Sabarabhashya on Jaiminiya Sutra, the Vishwasara Tantra, and other Vedic and philosophical treatises. This indicates that Udaya is well versed in almost all the branches of traditional knowledge. Now, the famous Melpathur Narayana Bhatta. The Sutta Slokas authored by Melpathur Narayana Bhatta, Sutra Slokas authored by Melpathur Narayana Bhatta, the poet philosopher of Kerala, and the author of the great work like Narayaniya, Prakriya Sarvasva, Dhadu Kavya, and Manam Ayodhaya is an important text from Kerala, the Sutta Slokas. It contains 9 verses. The characteristic feature of this work is that it is an explanation to the number of suttas and vargas included in the 8 ashtakas of Rigveda. Each verse, 2 to 9, is dedicated to each ashtaka. The first verse, a general introduction to the theme, is Natva vikneshwaradin kathama bijamaya kathyate vyanjanoktya suktanam varga sankhya sphudamihatu takaroktiradhyaya bhuttau yuktadhyam tulya suktanyu vadishadu bhavetva dvadasoktau ukshakara predisyadvidvigoktau After giving salutation to the Lord Vigneshwara and other deities, the author is going to speak about somehow the number of Veda, Vargas and Suktas in an Adhyaya very clearly using Vyanjanas. Though the method adopted for giving the number is based on Katapayaji system, it shows some deviations at particular instances from the traditional method. The letter Tha denotes the end of the chapter, not the digit 6 as in the normal case. Letter Tha is equal to 12 and Na to 10. Pra indicates 2 suktas and 4 vargas. In the combined letter, the first letter mentions sukta and sukta number and then the varga. From the second verse onwards, the poet brings the number of suktas and vargas in ashtakas 1 to 8 respectively. The second verse is Prodreka Adrida Rube Vimalava Ragira Purvagire Gururo Thargasri Gauri Gupta Akhilapura Gura Gupta Akhilapura Uraga Guru Prelia Koryagadaga Kereshta Prat Kereshta Pratera Gotara Padupiru Rukya Prame Pramaiva Hirapre Predya Vipravarye Ururayama Vibhirubini Me Gregasyad. Here it is the pro, pra means two suktas and 4 vargas, dre 8, 2 suktas 8, vargas 16. Prodre ka 1, 1, sukta 1, varga 1. Dri 8, 2, suktas 8, vargas 16. Ta, end of the adhyaya 1. Here in this method, he is giving the explanation. Here of the 2 numbers 2, 2, the first gives the number of sukta and the number of number resulted by their multiplication 2 into 2 denotes the number of vargas. Thus, total suktas are 19 and the total vargas are 37. Similarly, the numbers of suktas and vargas in the following adhyayas are given. That I am not going to speak about that. Of the 9 verses, 2 to 9 are peculiar in another way also, as they contain a meaning praising the goddess of Chandanakava, the family deity of Melpathur. This unique work had been commented recently by Dr. K. Vishnunampudiri, who is presently working as professor of Sanskrit Vyakarana at Payyanur Regional Center of Sri Shankaracharya University of Sanskrit, Kaladi, Kerala. The name of the commentary is Ganthaprada. The text along with the commentary has been included in the work Preservation Techniques of the Rigveda Chanting of Kerala edited jointly by Dr. C.M. Nilakanthan and the present scholar, and published by Sanskrit Vedic Studies, Center for Sanskrit Vedic Studies, Sri Shankaracharya University of Sanskrit, Kaladi, Kerala, with the financial assistance from UGC. The text and the commentary are very helpful to the students of Vedas to remember the number of adhyayas, suktas, and vargas in each ashtaka of Veda. As mentioned earlier, each verse is a praise in favor of the family deity of Venkatu. The meaning of the second verse given by the commentator is as follows. He Rodrega Adrida Rupe. Rodregam Adridam Rupam Yasya Sa Rodrega Adrida Rupa. Rodregam Pra Udregam. In this way, the commentary is going on. A general meaning of the second verse is as follows. General meaning. He prakrishtodhada visishte vaishishte prakrishta sabdayukte parvada shiva parvada shiva sangada akare nirmala abhirvagbhihi purvapurushai poojite shiva aishwaryayude gauri adrishye akhila jana sharira antasthide apratirodhya gati sahide nirmale kridana dalpare mekhashyama varnayukte atyanta nipunaihi panditaihi vistarena pratipadidatvad अत्यंतं कीर्तनीये प्राप्नुवदां जनानां प्रमामेव प्रदातुं उत्सहमाने अतिशीघ्र बुद्धिभिः प्रकर्षेण स्तूयमाने सा त्वं यथार्थरूपिणी भूत्वा मे अग्रदो वर्तमाना भव. This is the meaning of the first verse given by Professor K. Krishnanambudri. Now another scholar, Gargya Nilakantha, as Dr. Murlimathavan said, He is the author of an elaborate commentary on Nirukta of Yaska. The author, Garga Nilakanda, belongs to the family of Kontayur village situated on the banks of the Haradapura. Dr. Kunjan Raja says that it is a metrical commentary, and the author later on became a sannyasin by Nayam Padmapada Acharya. According to Dr. Raja, the scholar has been quoted as an authority by Payur Parameshwara in his commentary on the Spota Siddhi and by Kalallur Nilakanta Somayaji, as referred by Murli Madhavan sir, in his Aryabhriya Bhashya, which suggests that he must have lived at a period earlier than 14th century AD. Akitam Narayanan Nambudri. Narayanan Nambudri of Akitam family has written a commentary called Deepa Prabha on the Sarvanukramani, a commentary on Rigaveda Paribhasha of Savanaka. He has also written commentaries on other three works also, namely the Praisha of Unknown Authorship, Praishaarth Vivruti, Vararuja Sangraham, and Mahabhashya Pradeepa of Kayyata. The name of commentaries on all these texts is the name Deepa Prabha. The commentator has given sufficient information regarding his personal details in his work. He has referred to about his family name, native place, the deity Gold Narasimha, praised by him, his parents, and the name of the commentary written by him in the words found in Deepa Prabha on the Sarvanukramani and other Deepa Prabhas, which are as follows. Ahidagnya akhidam yatra geham gaunam prachakshade tatrol bhudena rachita ekaisha samskrutatmana grame bhavihārākhye jādena angirasam kule aryasudena tikeyam likhida वेशवर्मणां महाविहारपदये भजतां कल्पशाखिने नरसिंहात्मने लक्ष्मीनाथाय हरये नमः आर्याख्या जननीयस्य देवशर्म अभिदक्षिता आचार्यो देशिकस्यैव वेदवेदाङ्गतत्त्ववित् वेदो नाम महल्पदं जनपदं यत्र द्विजानां सदिस्साङ्गं वेदमधीत्य वाच्यमखिलं मीमांसदे सस्फुटं तत्र ग्रामवरे क्वचित् निवसता नाम्ना च नारायणेन ईशा He says that he was born in a village called Mahavihara and that he belonged to the Angirasa Gotra. In this connection, Kodullura and Vadakunkur says that the equivalent of the Sanskrit word Mahavihara is Perumpulli, a place situated near to Tripunathura in Kochi, Kerala, which assures that he is a Keralite. The family name Akitam seems to be the Malayalam equivalent of the Sanskrit word Ahidagni, which is given in the verse. Here, Vadakunkur opines that the word Ahidagni refers to the greatness of his family by performing sacrifices for generations. He says that it is a usual practice in Kerala to denote those people who has performed the sacrifice Agni as Akitiri, and the name Akittam may be a name given to a village where there were several such persons. He further explains that the portion of the verse Vedo Nama Mahalpadam Janapadam indicates the village Vengakkad, Venganat, and Mahaviharam is an Upagrama. Now, the Erkara Raman Nambudri. Raman Nambudri of Erkara family in Malabar was a prolific writer on Vedas in the 20th century. He was a master of Vedic subjects and final authority in the field of rituals and sacrificial matters. Raman Nambudri followed his ancestors in traditional Vedic learning and further acquired profound knowledge in Shraudha matters. After his primary education under Muriyat Achyuta Varya, he studied Rig Veda from his father. On completion of Vedic studies, he joined Pakaravur Gurugulam, where he studied Sanskrit in general and Upanishads and Kavya literature in particular. He participated in Shraudha sacrifices at the age of 13 and showed his mastery in the field. Then onwards, he became a permanent member of Vedic ritual performances in Kerala as well as other parts of India. Earlier, either as a Ritvik or as a coordinator. He was the head of the Athiratram held at Panyal in 1975. In 1997, he participated in the 32-day long Paundarigam Yajna held at Andhra Pradesh. The year is something missing. His performance is the Kadavallur Anyonyam was well appreciated. He had by hearted the entire Kaushidaki Brahmana and was recorded in 1946 by Tirupati Devasthanam. He showed enthusiasm even in the younger age to reach maximum heights in his studies. He had a definite vision regarding the result of his studies. He thought that every action should be resulted in for the upliftment and strengthening of common man. He realized that the traditional method of Vedic learning, though is essential for the preservation of the chanting tradition, and that culture suffers serious drawbacks. According to him, the scheme of study with total negation of meaning aspect of the mantras, even after completion of the Samhita and other pathas, will not help for the preservation of this great knowledge. Also, the restricted approach of Vedic study prevalent at that time to a particular class of people does not meet the needs of the day in a proper way. He thought about the solution to these serious problems and decided to find out necessary steps for the popularization of Vedic knowledge. The method chosen by him for the dissemination was not only mere lecturing, but academic writing also. Thus, he entered into the field of writing articles on Vedic topics and publishing them for the benefit of the entire human community. With the aim of society motivation and popularization of Vedic knowledge, he wrote three authentic books on Vedic subjects, Amnaya Madhanam, Ekaha Heena Satrangal, and Shravata Karma Vivekam, all in Malayalam language. Amnaya Madhanam was the first book written and was aimed at introducing the content of Vedic texts. As the name indicates, it was prepared by churning the ocean of Vedas to provide basic knowledge of Vedas and Vedas to the common man. It was published for the first time in December 1976. After giving a brief description on the word Veda, the author introduces the four Vedas, the Vedangas, the Upangas, and four Samhitas, Puramimamsa, various sacrifices, rituals of Atiratra, etc. There are 18 articles in the book. This book was selected for the Kerala Sahitya Academy Award. Ekaha Heena Satrangal and Shrauta Karma Vivegam are works related to rituals, the Karma Kanda. The author gives the structure of sacrifice, its basic and derived forms, definition of word Jyotishtoma, different sacrifices such as Ekaha, Ahina, Satra, and details of each of them. Raman Nambudiri, who believed that knowledge should be universal and all beneficial, was different from other orthodox Nambudiris of his period. He took initiation to start the journal Anadi from Tirunavaya Brahmaswam Matham with a vision of bringing the Vedic wisdom in the front line and approachable to all. The first issue of the journal was published in December 1972 and continued till 1985. In the beginning, it was a quarterly magazine. Later on, it got published monthly. The Tirunavaya Matham, Brahmaswam Matham has published one volume, the collection of old articles of Anadi, the Vedic papers, Vedic articles in one volume. And the next volume, they are trying to produce and hope that it will come soon come soon itself. Now I am going to the scholars of the second period, that I list a few here. This it is not the complete list. The first period also was is not complete, but for the time being, for the time is very limited, I am sharing the views of some of the scholars here. Vallathol Narayana Menon, V.K. Narayana Pattadiri, Dr. Sai Kunjan Raja, Erkara Raman Nambudiri, I have already played, Vedabandhu, OMC, and Kunjuni Raja and Sri Krishna Sarma. These are the scholars of the second period that I have already mentioned, Erkara Raman Nambudiri. Now, Vallathol Narayana Menon, the translation of the Rigveda into Malayalam by Vallathol Narayana Menon, the founder of Kerala Kalamandalam. Now, the Kerala Kalamandalam deemed to be university for arts and culture at Cheruthurthi, Thrissur district, Kerala, was an epoch-making event in the history of Kerala. It was published in 1955. He basically, being a poet, tried to introduce the Vedic hymns in a poetical manner, in a regional language, thinking that the public will be benefited by the effort. The translation prepared by him was attracted by the public, and they received the work with great enthusiasm. He made Rigveda approachable to everybody who wanted to know the content of Rigveda and its literature. Though there are so many limitations to his translation, it helped to generate a new outlook regarding Veda through this attempt. He tried to connect the ideas of Vedic hymns with the social and national reformation movements. Getting inspiration from the Rigvedic commentary, he later on authored several other works, thinking that the guiding spirit of the poetry itself is in Vedas. Then OMC Narayanan Nambudiri Pad. Revi Prasadam Bhasha Bhashya of Rigveda in Malayalam, written by OMC Narayanan Nambudiri Pad, is another important exegetical work from Kerala. The commentator was born in 1910. After his primary education, he studied Veda and Sanskrit in Sanskrit. In 1934, he passed the BA degree and joined in the literary mission and cultural and social reformatory movements. After spending the youth period in the national organizations, thus, he began to translate Rigveda at the age of around 60. His translation of the entire Rigveda Samhita comprises 8 volumes, each volume dedicating to each Ashtaka. Through this remarkable work, he has disclosed the entire Rigveda for the benefit of the whole Keralaites, because it is in Malayalam. He used the commentary of Sayana for his translations. The whole project was completed in 1986 with the translation of the eighth volume. He gives the prose order, meaning in Sanskrit and Malayalam for each word in a mantra, and provides additional explanation also if it feels necessary. Coming to V.K. Narayana Pattadiri, he was a profound scholar in Vedic lore in all its ramifications. He had traditional anchoring in Vedic studies, which he tried to supplement with his ever deep explorations of the meaning of the Vedas, grossly neglected in orthodox pedagogical methods. His whole thought and work was a hermeneutical endeavor. He, with broad-minded and human approach to Vedic lore, honestly believed that the Vedas have relevance in the contemporary society as much as they cherished the values of universal brotherhood. During the first half of the 20th century, when conservative ideas of Vedic learning preserved in Kerala, as elsewhere in India, Pattadiri strongly demanded for the interpretation of Vedas, maintaining a profound reverence to them. He made pioneering contribution to Vedic literature in Malayalam language by exploring the teaching of Vedas. He tried to introduce an element of his Vedic vision in every single piece of his writing. He thereby upheld relevance of the Vedas to modern times as well. The writings of Narayana Pattadiri are based mainly on the sacrificial aspects reflected in Vedas. The important works are Yajna Samskaram, Vedartha Vijaram, Vedam Dharmamulam, Veda Sandesham, and Veda Swarupa. He has done his studies mostly on spiritual point of view, as inspired by the teachings of Aurobindo. So these are the few scholars that I want to study in this lecture, and I want to present before you. Dr. Srikrishna Sharma, Dr. Kunjan Raja, Dr. Vedabandhu, that is Dr. R. Vengadachala Iyer. Also, all these, Dr. Kunjan Raja, all these scholars had made immense contribution to the Vedic Society of Kerala, as Professor Murlimadhavan said, Srikrishna Sharma, and I referred to, he has edited the two works and other works also to the Vedic Studies of Kerala. Now, I going to the other stage, that the institutions and disseminations which was held in Kerala from the traditional and modern point of view. Traditionally, there were two Brahmasammathams in the teaching and learning of Rigveda in Kerala, that is Thrissur Brahmasammatham and Tirunavaya Brahmasammatham. Between the two, Vadakkaimatham Brahmasam Thrissur is alive today, and Tirunavaya Brahmasammatham is not alive. There is no learning at the Tirunavaya Brahmasammatham. But at Thrissur, nowadays, both Rigveda and Yajurveda is being taught. Yajurveda is also taught at Kanchikamagudi Yajurveda Pathashala, Irinyalakuda, an institution entirely for the Taittiriya Samhita of Yajurveda, Krishna Yajurveda. Then Samaveda Gurukulam at Panyal, Thrissur district, there was a Gurukulam, but now it is not working. And these are the traditional Vedic institutions in Kerala. And beyond this, some Nambudiri families were also institutionalized as in the former years. The Narayana Mangratmana, nowadays the Saudasmartha Gurukulam was an institution, almost an institution where the Rigveda was taught. Coming to the modern age, in the dissemination of the Vedic learning and the Vedic knowledge, in a more recent way or more general way, some institutions are being taking steps, and some books are being published from some institutions. Among them, Sri Shankaracharya University of Sanskrit Kalyani, the Center for Vedic Studies, is working for the dissemination of Vedic knowledge. Shankaran Nambudiri Padasmarga Granthashala Kanipayur is publishing texts on Vedic subjects. And Kadavallur Anyonyam Parishat, yes, I have to say something about Kadavallur Anyonyam in this respect that I will present. Kadavallur Anyonyam Parishat also is providing such a good presentation in providing this or preserving this Vedic tradition. Acharya Narendra Bhushan Foundation, Chengannur, the Kashyapa Research Foundation, Kozhikode, and as I said, Saudasmartha Gurukulam Narayana Mangratmana, Edappal. All these are institutions in modern times to study and disseminate the Vedic learning and Vedic teachings. Now, the projects and researches that we undergone in Kerala in recent times in the preservation and exploration of Vedic matters is the Jaiminiya Samaveda documentation project done by Center for Vedic Studies, SSUS Kalyani. Jaiminiya Samaveda project done with the financial help of National Manuscript Mission, National Mission for Manuscripts, New Delhi at Hill Palace, Trikonathura. Taittiriya Samhita Documentation Project, Vedic Research Center, done by Vedic Research Center, Vadakkaimatham Brahmasam, Thrissur. Anadi Project, Tirunavaya Brahmasam Matham, Tavanur. Then first volume is it has come, and the other volumes will come soon. Kadavallur Anyonyam Parishat, Kadavallur Anyonyam Documentation, done by IGNCA, New Delhi. And Kaushidagi Brahmana Project at Narayana Mangalathumana, Edappal, the teaching of Kaushidagi Brahmana to the next generation. Some important researches in this field already done are Sugatha Commentary on Kaushidagi Brahmana, a critical study. The present scholar completed the work. Then Narayaniya Vyakhya of Akitam Narayana Nambudiri on Krut Sarvanukramani, a critical edition with study done by Dr. A.M. Keshavan. Then Ananda Chandrika Commentary on Aswarayana Grishya Sutra, a critical edition with the study, Dr. Sudhanjali P.S. Now, the works of Shadguru Shishya on Vedic literature, it is going on. So in the present scenario, the teaching and learning and research works are going on in Kerala as part of the dissemination of Vedic learning and Vedic texts here. In this way, we have a good volume of texts and teachers. We had a good volume of texts and teachers, and also we have that I have not attempted here, because in the recently after 1980s or 90s, we have several publications from Kadavallur Anyonya Parishat, Kanipayur Sangram Nambudiri Padasmarga Granthashala, and other Thrissur Vadakkai Matham Brahmastham Thrissur, and other centers of Veda were in Kerala, where this process is going on. And regarding Kadavallur Anyonyam, I will conclude my paper by saying something about Kadavallur Anyonyam, because it has its importance in the preservation of Kerala Vedic tradition. Kadavallur Anyonyam is a ritual practice come method of preservation used to maintain the traditional method of chanting of Rigveda in Kerala. It's a Vedic chanting examination conducted every year in the middle of the month November, first 10 days of Malayalam month, Vrishchikam, at the premises of Sri Ramaswamy Temple, Kadavallur, near Thrissur, Kerala. The participants of this particular type of debate are Nampudris of Kerala belonging to Rigveda. The Rigvedic pundits attached to the two traditional Rigveda Pathashalas in Kerala, the Thrissur and Tirunavaya Brahmaswam Mathas, meet every year at the Sri Ramaswamy Temple at Kadavallur and examine the scholars in each group in the higher levels of chanting of Rigveda like Kramapatha, Jatapatha, and Rathapatha. High honors and titles like Mumpilirikkal, Kadanirikkal, and Valiya Kadanirikkal are given to those who become successful in such examinations. Usually, the ceremony is conducted for 8 days, each day devoted to each Ashtaka of Veda. Earlier in some years, ceremony was conducted for 16 days or 24 days in this way, taking into consideration of the increasing number of participants ready to examination. The word Anyonyam means face-to-face, denoting the practice of sitting the two groups of Rigvedians face-to-face in the ceremony. They examine the Vedic scholarship each other. Of the two groups, one can be distinguished as instructing or questioning side, and the other as obeying or answering side. The process of questioning and answering is very particular to mention. No oral instruction is given to the opposite side regarding the portion to be chanted. It is being intimated by touching some of the stones placed in a particular order. 12 small stones are used for the purpose. The chanter has to identify the portion to be chanted in this way. He can take a few minutes to remember the portion and has to begin the chanting in the Kramapatha method. Those who chant the entire portion without making any mistake become successful in Anyonyam and are highly honored in the society. The titles or honors conferred to them are like to the higher degrees of the present day. This practice helps for the preservation of the Rigveda chanting intact and memorizing the whole text. No such practice is conducted for Yajurveda and Samaveda in Kerala or for any other Vedas in any other parts of India. This unique event conducted for the preservation of the Rigveda chanting tradition is continuing now. It has a long history of many centuries, but only feeble references are available. It is believed that this traditional chanting practice has three distinct phases. The earliest phase up to 1947. The middle phase 1947 to 1989, and a new phase 1989-2011. Traditional Vedic pundits of Kerala are of opinion that the event had occurred a break in 1947 due to some political issues, the Kshetra Praveshana Vilambaram in Malabar and Kochi. Regarding the institution of this great event, specific and trustworthy data is not available. Historians like S. Sridhar Menon takes it to the 11th century AD and says that during the reign of Parashekharas of Mahodayapura, this was in practice. But this statement cannot be taken for granted. It is known from references that it was started at Mulankunnathukavu Shastra Temple situated near Thrissur, and later on it was shifted to Kadavallur due to some internal politics and disputes between the two sets of participants. In this way, the practice, which was known as Anyonyam, changed its name and came to be known as Kadavallur Anyonyam. Now, let me conclude with some remarks. The studies on Vedic literature currently going on are mainly based on an interdisciplinary approach in Kerala. This modern outlook or in study of Vedas helped to establish a strong base on Vedic studies in Kerala, which will be definitely benefited to the coming generations. People are approaching the studies on Vedas very eagerly and enthusiastically nowadays in Kerala. Seminars, workshops, and literary discussions are being conducted every now and then here. A number of treatises on Vedas, Vedangas, and allied topics are being published recently from different publications, institutions of Kerala. Kadavalur Anyunya Parishat, Kanipayur Sankaran Nampudiripad Samaraka Granthasala, Brahmasammathams, the traditional Vedic institutions at Thrissur and Tirunavaya, Acharya Narendra Bhushan Foundation, Chengannur, Kottayam are some of them. All these studies are of great academic importance and are apt evidences for the revivalism in the field of Vedic studies in Kerala. With these words, let me back. Thanks to one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. It has been a lucid account of the immense contribution made by Kerala writers to the Vedic exegetic literature. And you have presented very well the paper. And now it's open for discussion. First, I invite the president of the program, Murali Madhavan sir, to make a few observations.
Is it audible to me? Audible?
Sir.
Yes, yes sir.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. See, the presentation done by Professor K. Ravindran is very, as Dr. Ajithan has told you, very lucid and very to the point. And he has covered almost all areas of Vedic contribution, not only exegesis. Exegesis also have some role to playing, as he well explained, that the areas of teaching, learning, and even in translation, and all those areas, when he was discussing Vallathol's translation, he has made it very clear, and OMC's translation, all those things he had touched very beautifully, and even the modern scholars, starting from Dr. C. Kunjan Raja. Professor C. Kunjan Raja is the first ambassador of Vedic ambassador from India to go abroad and study Vedas under great stalwarts like Professor Arthur A. MacDonald, then John Bruff, and such internet like that, such great scholars of that order. But what he has studied under MacDonald, Professor C. Kunjan Raja, what he has studied under MacDonald, the theory of MacDonald and his followers or his contemporaries, is more or less it was like that Sayana has wrote his Bhashya without any basis. He has not based any pre-Bhashyas or pre-commentaries or what we call prior to him. This was the theory of Professor MacDonald. Professor Raja, when he was undergoing his post-graduation and research in Oxford University, he was not at all happy and he is not satisfied with this type of teaching and learning process. He came to India after his after obtaining his degree. Even reaching before India, he went to Germany. He met the great Indologists there in France, in Germany, in other parts of the European countries. And he had a very detailed discussion on with the Vedic literature, especially on Sayana Bhashya. Then, after coming to India, once he stepped in this land, he was on war foot. He was working for unearthing manuscripts, those who are prior to Shankar, prior to Sayana. And he could bring out, unearth more than 7 or 8 commentaries. Some commentaries are not in full, only partial. Some portions are being commented upon and some are incomplete and like that. But so many commentaries he got with the full text, with the full commentary. And he proved beyond doubt and he refuted all the theories of his own teachers, including Professor MacDonald. And he established that Sayana has based the earlier commentaries on Rigveda, and based on earlier Bhashyas, he has furthered the subject. Furthering the subject was done by Sayana in commentarial field. So this was the this has happened, and this has when we talk about Kerala, first the name of Dr. C. Kunjanraja comes to our mind, dawned to our mind. Then automatically modern scholars, Dr. E. R. Shesha Sharma, Dr. K. Kunjanraja, and such people are there in the line. And among modern scholars who are just what we can say or claim as our contemporaries, senior contemporaries, like Arkar Ramanambudri, such great stalwarts, their contributions. And like Narayana Bhattadri, V.K. Narayana Bhattadri, Vedabandhu, and such OMC. Professor Ravindran has touched all the fields and even minute areas, very minor and even insignificant areas are being touched upon by Professor Ravindran while he was discussing the contributions of Vedic exegesis from Kerala, by Kerala scholars. So I am very happy and also proud that Kandaru Shala could arrange its 5th lecture on Vedic exegesis. We have started the 2 series of lectures, one on Indian intellectual tradition, other one on wheels, that is Vedic epistemology and exegesis. So this is the 5th lecture in Vedic exegesis. It started with Nirukta, Shiksha. It started with the Vedanga Shiksha by Professor Vishnu, and several young scholars have participated, and including Professor Jiyu Dhite and such great scholars from Pune. They have participated in the Kandalur platform. They have delivered very authentic speeches on Vedic literature, Vedic commentaries, Vedic recensions, and like that, so many areas of Vedic study. So we are happy that Kandaru Shala could bring out these lectures in the expected fashion with authentically. And these lectures are being recorded and kept safe in our site, and also in the through link, it is available in the YouTube also. So anybody, any scholar, at any time, according to his convenience, the convenience of the student, convenience of the researcher, they can open the lecture, they can hear the lecture, and they can even raise doubts to the scholars and clear their doubts, and bring a platform of discussion where they can enrich the topics, the discussions we have already started. So Kandaru Shala is always for that. And we are happy that we are getting a good team of scholars for delivering the lectures. Now, I have a small clarification I want. Professor Ravindran is a good scholar in Vedic field. So I want to know his opinion about it. That there is a strong belief and there is a strong view, rather, that Kaushatigi Brahmana and Sanghayana Brahmana are the same. We find it in two different, with much difference. But in some places, still people, they Kaushitagins, Sanghayanas, and like that, they as group, they say separately, and in some places, as I mentioned in my presidential address that in some places they are identical. So what is the opinion of Professor Ravindran in this matter? This I want to get as small clarification from him, his opinion about it, from his knowledge. And I have a request to the scholars who are participating today in the Kandaroo platform, that we have a wonderful international academic fest on Narayaniyam on 13th of December, that is day after tomorrow, on Monday, at 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. Great scholars from states, from other place, Canada and other places, they are participating. They are performing also. Some performances are also on stage. Performance are also there on Narayaniyam, exclusively on Narayaniyam, 3 hours program. And scholars like Professor George Cardona, who has contributed much in the field, Professor C.L. Prabhakar and such great scholars, Professor N.P. Unni, such scholars are participating in it and delivering lectures on different areas of contributions of Narayana Bhattadhiri and also mainly on Narayaniyam. And I request the learned scholars of Kandaroo Shala platform to attend day after tomorrow's program. If they are, if they could not get the link will be given. Link is available in the our website also. If you type Kandaroo Shala, immediately that site ID will come and you can get it from there also. So with these observations, I beg to remain. Thanks for active participation in the lecture. Thank you.
Sir,
yes. I request Sri Narayanan Poti to give his observations on this paper.
Okay, and I will speak after that.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your presidential address. It almost covered, but through a good lecture and exposition, Sri Ravindran sir penetrated into subject and shown many points in a comprehensive fashion. A very good scholastic presentation. I am very much proud of today's event. And I am having one doubt also, because as you said, the Nirukta Shlagavartikam of this Padmapada or Nilakanda Gargiya, you quoted a portion of the verses of the author itself. That Nilakanta Chaturveda Pitrbhyo Yasya Dharmika Bhuyaji Chaturveda Rudra Sarma Pitamaha. What it shows, here a common belief is there in prevalent in the traditional orthodox conservative section of Veda Pandits. Even in, I am required to say, in Nambudri Veda Pandits also, thus in Kerala, this Atharvaveda was excluded from time immemorial. But it is not correct, because here Nilakanta Gargiya says that his father was a Chaturveda Pandit. So what it shows, in before 14th century, the study of Atharvaveda was prevalent, or maybe in extinction stage, but that tradition was there in Kerala. That point you all of us have to ponder over. Then another point, the traditional pundits usually, again, forgive me, they may say that Anarthakalaki Mantra in a Kamsa school. But the old, the Bhashyas, Niruktas, and the ancestral contributions of Kerala Pandits like Udaya, Bhavatrada, Nilakanta Gargiya, Melpathur, Narayana Bhattadhiri, and those expositions, those valuable contributions shows that in Kerala, an importance was given to the Nirupta Yaska. In Kerala, the ancestors were well-versed in Veda and Shravada. They give much importance to the Artha, the meaning of Veda, and Yaska Niruptam. That now related to the background and Kautsa's Nirarthavada is prevalent. These 2 points, kindly the scholars ponder over it and the importance to these factors, these 2 factors about the Kerala tradition. So the present lecture shows a direction, a new direction to the original tradition of Kerala. I am expressing my deep heartfelt thanks and to you scholars who conducted this event. And one more point, in even though Kandalu Shala is a baby just born 1 year before, in Kerala, under the leadership of Dr. Burli Madhavan sir, Kandalu Shala has given an immense contribution to the dissemination of Vedic thoughts and Vedic culture within 1 year. It is accepted internationally. So by considering the dissemination of the Vedic culture in this newly born child under the leadership of Kandalu Shala, under the leadership of Dr. Murali Madhavan, the Kandalu Shala also to be mentioned. That is my request. That is my humble request. Moreover, Kandalu Shala is actually reviving a tradition of thousands of years, more and older than all these institutions mentioned in Dr. In this lecture of present day's lecture. So we are expecting that Kandalu Shala will be able to contribute more for the dissemination of Vedic culture of Kerala and elsewhere to popularize this Vedic exegesis. And one more request, this rare text, some of the text, a critical edition, going to be published. I am happy to hear it. But some other texts also should be included. And well established universities like Kaladi Sarvakalashala, Sanskrit University can contribute, because Mepathur Narayana Bhattadri himself wrote a Shravada Bhashyam, and Bhavatrada wrote an entire Samyaveda Jaimini Shravada Bhashyam. So these contributions to be revived and published, critical editions to be published, and if possible, kindly make available in the resources of your online resources of the university depositories. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, I have a humble observation that we scholars, we should work in a team jointly with other sister institutions, like in higher learning and research, like Kaladi Shankaracharya University, Tirupati Sanskrit Vidyapeetha, Rashtriya Samskrit Samsthan, like that Sandeepani Veda Vidyapatishthan, and such institutions, we have to go hand in hand. We have to work and see that we can bring more valuable editions of our ancient texts. And there are sufficient money for publication of these works. There are nobody to extract that money and use it properly. Government of India is giving, they are set apart a very huge amount for publication of these Vedic texts, mainly Vedic texts exclusively. But the so-called Vedic institutions, they should come forward and they should take up these issues. And even published books, you can have a second edition and with more information. In the previous edition, there will be less information. But we have studied after 10 years. We have studied a book, and then we got more information after deliberations and discussions. And we got those informations, new informations, we can interpolate in the second edition. And like that, we can have second editions also, or third edition also, like that. Any, whatever may be. What I want to say is that here the scholars, they should take, considering to relating to other subjects, Vedic area, Vedic knowledge, Vedic texts, there is sufficient money sponsored by government of India for publication, for providing financial assistance to Vedic scholars and Vedic institutions. We have to take up that matter, and we have to submit the proper projects of publication of some kind of research and higher studies in the subject, and conducting higher classes. Such things we have to think of. And these are some, when Professor Sri Narayan Bhoti, when he discussed these matters with some kind of foresight, I want to add something more, what he has already told by Sri Narayan Bhoti. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Now, I think among scholars, we have regularly, we have several scholars like Arundanjan Mishra is from Shanti Niketan, our good scholar. He is delivering a lecture on Kashmir Shaivism, our Pratibhidnya philosophy. He has already accepted that it will come in the month of January, last of February. And Dr. Shashi Rekha is here, and such scholars are here, and I expect some contribution in the form of participation in the discussion from them. Professor Arundanjan Mishraji, can you hear me? Not
yes, sir.
Yeah,
no, please.
I am very happy.
Yes, sir. I had a very small question. Professor Ravindran said that there would be a kind of division pre 18th century and post 18th century of Vedic studies in Kerala. And I wish to know the rationalism behind it.
Rationality
behind it. Why should we divide it before 1880 and post 1880?
Okay. The meaning of that bifurcation.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Arundanjan ji. Thank you. I think your busy schedules in the university is over.
No, it's going on, but Nag has returned, fortunately.
Okay. I am very happy that you are, in spite of your busy schedule, you could find time to attend our
function. Thank you, sir.
Dr. Ravindran will clarify his position at the end, fag end of the lecture, after raising all questions. Okay. If anybody want to ask any question, they can ask now.
Sir, namaste. Namaste to all. Namaste to Murli Madhavan.
Namaste, Shashirekha ji.
Namaste. Sir, actually, this Anyonyam, I heard about it. Professor Shashiprabha, once she attended and she was narrating how it is. I'm very happy. Yeah. I always admire Kerala scholarship. So I feel once a small demo If it is, you know, like presented here, that Anyonyam, I think many scholars, because I did not see it anywhere, even in our Andhra Pradesh, I never saw such a practice, that Anyonyam style. So once it is, I think, just, you know, as you are doing our Nrutta Shilpa something in a forthcoming seminar, once a small one, at least, I think it will automatically it will be available in the link. And we can show somewhere, that is, because it is very intellectual feast. It is not an ordinary one. And congratulations and thanks to Ravindran ji, because such a lucid and a very clear, and the arrangement is also for us. We got lot of information. We are really benefited. Why we are attending means, sir, we are benefited by the lectures. There is some selfishness is also there. So really, this Kantallur Shala lectures, all we are getting some new information. We are enlightened. At least we are, now we are learning something. Even at this age, we are, after stopping everything, now again, there is a door opened to us to know something. So thank you so much to all the scholars, and particularly you, sir, and Ravindranji. It's wonderful. It's wonderful. I am very, very happy. So much of work done and very systematically presented. That's more important. Such a vast area covered within the given time. He has not really exceeded the time also. So nice of you, sir. Namaste. All the best to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Shirekha.
Your
suggestion is very good. The president of the session, I would like to give this proposal to the, it's a new proposal, very good proposal, proposal given by you. Actually, madam, we want this type of proposal from scholars. Kandarur Shala will be enriched by these things. Our motto is only to enrich this knowledge, nothing more.
So what we are going to do is that we will conduct
a small exhibition of this Anyonyam on the stage, on the platform.
It will be received internationally. It will be welcomed, sir.
With the proper homework and planning, we will do it.
It is, because Kerala's contribution, that is.
It is exclusively only in Kerala you can get it.
Yes, that's
very good.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, what about the further discussion? Any other questions? Hello?
No, sir. So far, no questions in the chat box also.
I also think no more questions.
Yes. So, Dr. Ravindran, now this is the time for you to give clarifications, and if any answers to any questions.
This is the time. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you all for your good words regarding the paper. First, Professor Murali Madhavan said that is there any what is the relation between Kaushidhi Brahmana and Sankhayana Brahmana? Of course, it's a good question, but I think that I could not refer to the Sankhayana Brahmana text as it is, like Kaushidhi Brahmana, during my PhD work. I went through the whole text of Kaushidhi Brahmana at that time, because it was the commentary by Udaya that I have particularly studied. So I had the opportunity to go through the entire text, but I could not locate the Sankhayana Brahmana as the text. The 30 chapters. Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Okay. I could not go through the entire text of Sankhya Brahmana. So still I am in doubt that whether the texts are one and the same or different. That is the text is available with anybody? So I want to know that also. If that text of Sankhya Brahmana with 30 or in Kaushalya Brahmana, there are 30 chapters and several lacunes, several texts, several blanks are there. Is the same, is it the same, the Sankhya Brahmana with the same extra copy, what we can say, the exact copy of Sankhya Brahmana. That I have to check with the text itself.
The problem is that in Gujarat and in some areas of Maharashtra,
yeah,
I have traveled there while I was doing some research on Sama chanting and its vigridis. And I came met some scholars. Some are Sanghayanas and some are Kaushitakins.
They
have different Brahmanas, what they say. But they say that. So I think we can discuss that and we can look into. We cannot say any final thing now. But we have to go through, as you said, we have to go through the text and see.
Yes. There is another point called the Vinaya Bhatta's commentary for Kaushitika Brahmana. That also I could not locate.
Only
from reference. So in this case, Sankhya Aranyaka is there. The text is available.
Yes.
Sankhya Brahmana, I don't know the text is available or not. And Sankhya this Brahmana. So that we have to go word by word with these two texts. Then only we can surely say that both are same or not. That we have to look. In another occasion, that we have to collect the text if it is available. I am asking the text is available or not with anybody of our scholars. If it is available, please have a copy to me also.
What I could grasp from the discussions of the scholars that I met with Professor Dete and some other scholars from Pune, our Padaskar. Bhagiratha Padaskar and such great Vedic scholars discuss with them. From the discussions and with some other scholars also, what I could grasp is that there is some minor differences in these two. Several portions are same. So maybe due to some Ajara Bheda, some two groups have been formed and doing in slightly different way. And these type of texts have been evolved in that way.
Yes, maybe.
Maybe that is the reason, perhaps.
Okay. We have to look. We will look.
Okay.
Yes. Then, Dr. Pothi sir, thank you for your information and thank you for your presentation regarding the paper. I think there is no question, I think, because this regarding the Atharva Veda tradition, it's a new information to me that most of us believe that in Kerala, from the very time immemorial, there is no Atharva Vedic tradition relevant. The other three Vedas are there, Yajus and Sama is there, but regarding the Atharva Veda, it is a new information and thank you for the same. I want to ask you that whether the...
There Narayan Bhatti has mentioned the shloka, which I have, also quoted, I think so. I have also quoted.
I have quoted.
Kira Sharma Pita Yasya Yajva Yatnik Sharadaha Bahu Yajvi Chaduru Vedo Rudra Sharma Pitamaha. So his Pitamaha, Nilakandha's Pitamaha was a Chaduruvedi.
Yes, maybe.
That is the thing. That is what Pothi has mentioned.
Yes.
Okay.
Also that he has referred to the Gautradas Jaiminiya Bhashya. I want to know whether it is available or not in manuscript form or in any transcript form that I want to know. I have searched for the text at several places. I could not collect it during my research.
It is available in a printed form in Sanskrit.
Okay.
A big volume printed in Sanskrit text is available.
From where? From where it was printed?
And do you know the publisher?
I don't remember now. I will message you. Sir.
Okay. I
got that information from Dr. Magarabhushanam Bhadia of Tirunelveli. I think it was published 30 years before from Bombay.
Yes. Because at that time I was searching for that, and I knew that it was a manuscript is available at Magarapur family, but I could not collect that.
When from Harvard University, from Canada, my friend gave a copy to Thottam Sivakaran Namboori also for entire Bhadrada Bhashya.
Okay.
Kandanjada Narayanan NambooriNarayanan Nambooriin Canada, he told me that he took a copy from Harvard University and gave to Sivakaran Namboori
Yes.
From Canada, Kandanjada Nambooriwas attending the function, our meeting.
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Narayanta. Thank you very much. wonderful question. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you then.
Okay, now.
Yes. Dr. Arun Ranjan Mishra, thank you for your information and...I made just for my convenience that such a division for first period and second period. No, there is no any specific reason for that. We can divide it in many ways: ancient period, medieval period, modern period. In such and such cases, such and such days, ancient period up to such a date, and medieval period up to such a date, and modern period. Such a division is also there. For my convenience, today's lecture I made to such a type of division.
I found a justification in your bifurcation because, as I told you that in the modern time, in the medium of English, studying English and modern shastras and modern subjects, Professor C. Kunjanraja is the first person who was born there and done started. It starts in 1800. That's the thing.
Yes.
So that may be a new era, of Vedic exegesis.
Yes. That is perhaps the century when there was a kind of breaking the ice between East and West.
We could actually understand
their interpretation of the Veda.
Exactly. Arun Ranjan ji, I will tell you that Professor C. Kunjanraja is the first man from India to go outside as a Vedic ambassador. He traveled a lot at length and breadth of Europe and even in American states and other places.And collected whatever in the form of manuscript and other things, they have all informations. And even then, he could not refute his teacher. Under MacDonald, he has done PhD. But he was taught that Sayana was writing baselessly, without any base. But he was a first man to come into India. And first, his mission was to collect pre-Sayana Bhashyas.And he was succeeded, and he got six or seven manuscripts from different parts of Kerala, and even from Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. And he published it one after another, and he established and he refuted his teacher's all theories. So he proved it. So that is a new era. That is what I want to say.
Yeah.Thank you, sir. Thank you, Ravindran ji.
Okay.
Yes.
Moreover, that all the scholars that we have mentioned here are not with us for the time being. That's a...
Yeah. All the scholars. All our professors, our teachers.
Yes. Further that, we have so many scholars in the modern age, but I have not gone through them because they are living scholars. There are living scholars, but I have, with the lack of time, I could not follow, I could not collect their...I have data, but I could not speak about them in the modern 19th century and so 20th century. There are several contributors in this regard. So we have 2 or 3 hours to discuss. We have to do a discussion in 2 or 3 hours to cover all these topics or all these persons who have contributed immensely to the Kerala Vedic culture and Kerala Vedic tradition. So.In this respect, I think I have given a very little, it is a minimum that I have presented before you, the contribution of Kerala. If we with more time, we will discuss the contribution in a more enlarged, more great manner. That's up to
you. Yes.
And also, Dr. Sashirekha, do you remember me? I don't know. Do you know me? Or I know you. That it is very great that your words are.
I remember, sir. I remember. Why not?
Okay.
So
okay.
many times okay. I visited Kerala, more than I think 10 times I visited Kaladi.
Yes, Kaladi.
Only the thing is, Palitakeshaha, we are becoming, our age is seen on our hair. Slight okay. changes are there in appearance, but the, but of course the name when I heard immediately, and I know I am so much associated with Kerala. That is
the yes, yes, yes. But I, you could not come to Kadavallur, I think.
Kadavallur, yes. I visited, sir. Once with Neelakantan, Neelakantan, sir, has arranged. I saw the temple. I really cherish the sambar in a temple. I thought, okay, what a beautiful temple, what a very large idols.
Okay.
Sir, I love everything belonging to Kerala.
Okay, thank you.
And particularly knowledge, there's no doubt, sir. I am from Andhra Pradesh, but really I admire, particularly the Vedic studies are imparted to one and all. This I like, that is integrated India. So there are so many points, as you say. I think some another platform is required, because the unbiased and it is distributed to one and all, particularly Brahmins, non-Brahmins, such categorization is not there. I love it. Real Indian culture is settled down. People say God's country, something, God's state. So it is true. It is true. Saraswati Sthana. There is no doubt about it. I love it, sir, from the bottom of my heart. I love Kerala for its rich culture, heritage, and like Narayani, so many Malayala works, you know, how many, their contribution is human service, sir. Because here in Telugu, we don't find so many varieties of books. So poetry might be there, but other, I'm not really blaming my motherland. But the thing is, I feel, that's all. So
I
admire, at least wherever the Saraswati is there, I admire, and that's the reason my salutations.
Okay, thank you. Hope to meet you again in Kerala recently.
Yeah.
Dr. Arunanjan Mishra also, we hope to meet you at Kaladi or Kadavallur and Kerala at any places.
Oh yes, I had been there twice.
Twice in Kerala.
Yeah.
I recognized even Arunanjan Mishra also.
So oh, namaskar.
Namaskar.
We have met in Pune.
We met in many.
Huh? Misraji will be coming to our platform soon.
Yeah, yes, okay. Thank you. Because we met so many times, you know.
Namaste, namaste.
Seminars meeting, yeah.
We should have a continuous effort to, what we call, to be live in our academic discussion. Then only we will be happy. We worked for money for several years. Now we work for happiness.
This gives us pure happiness. Pure happiness.
And teacher never retires.
It is equal to final emancipation.
Yes.
Yes.
So nice, sir. Today, very nice. Nice to see you.
Very good. Thank you for all scholars, to those who assembled here in this Kandalur platform.
Yeah.
And they're very happy to see from Bengal, our great friend Arunanjanji. We were together in Kaladi and in several other places.
Yeah.
So that is a very good memories we have, very sweet memories of association.
Yeah, we have met in Pune, in Delhi, in Kaladi.
Several places.
In all India Oriental conferences.
Surely. Thank you. So Dr. Ajithan, we will go to next item.
Yes, sir. Thank you for a wonderful presentation and meaningful discussions. We are moving on to next item. It's presentation of citation to Dr. K. Ravindran. today's speaker. It's given by Dr. V. Nirmala. Though she is a student of Sanskrit literature, she has special interest in Kashmir Shaivism, and she has brought out a wonderful thesis on Shakti, the aspect of Shakti in Kashmir Shaivism. I invite Dr. V. Nirmala to present the citation to Dr. K. Ravindra.
Thank you so much. Good evening, everybody. First of all, I would like to express my gratitude to Murali Madhavan sir for making me part of this such a great academic event. And it's also a matter of great pleasure that I'm having this opportunity to present citation to my own teacher, Ravindran sir. So let me begin. With great honor and respect, Kantarlur Shala highly commends Dr. K.A. Ravindran for his outstanding contribution and exemplary work in Vedic literature as a young Sanskrit scholar, writer, and teacher. Dr. K.A. Ravindran is a professor of Sanskrit Sahitya and coordinator of Center for Vedic Studies at the Sri Shankaracharya University of Sanskrit, Kaladi. He did MA, MPhil, and received PhD from Sri Shankaracharya University of Sanskrit, Kaladi. His PhD was on the topic Sukhada Commentary on Kaushitaki Brahmana, a critical study. He is associated in the project of audio-visual documentation of Jaiminiya Samaveda of Kerala Nampudiri tradition, carried out by Center for Vedic Studies with financial assistance from Ministry of Culture, Government of India. Dr. Ravindran has 23 years of teaching experience in PG classes, research experience, and also guided 7 PhD scholars. He is an author of the book Samaveda Darpanam, published in 2007, and editor of 26 books. He translated the book Indian Theories of Meaning by Dr. K. Kunjuni Raja into Malayalam, Artham Bharatiya Siddhantangal. Some of his ongoing project works are editing and publishing from manuscripts, the work in Tantra named Kriya Sara of Ravi from Kerala, with 2 unpublished commentaries in Sanskrit of Kerala, Anadi project by Tirunavaya Brahmaswamatham, Turuktavanur, Malappuram, Kerala, reprinting of the articles of old Anadi publications in book form, and project of compilation and reprinting of the works of Panditar E.V. Raman Nambudiri. Dr. Ravindran was honored with Samskrita Ratna Award instituted by IISH Trivandrum in 2006 and received Veda Bandhu Award in 2011 from Kadavallur Anyonya Parishad for contributions in the field of Vedic studies. Thank you all for listening to this. Thank you once again. This presented to Dr. K. Ravindran on Saturday, the 11th December 2021 at Thiruvananthapuram.
Thank you, Nirmala. Next is proposing vote of thanks. I invite Dr. Shamsir PC. He is an assistant professor of Sanskrit, Kerala University. So, Shamsir.
A very good evening to all. Most respected chair of the session, our most beloved teacher, Professor P.C. Murali Madhavan, sir, the speaker of the day, Dr. K. Ravindran, sir, other part of the dignitaries, Dr. Pradeep Jyothi, sir, Dr. Nirmala V., Dr. Sarida Maheshwaran, Dr. Arun Ranjan, Dr. P. Shashirekha, Dr. Ajitan P.I., other colleagues and friends, teachers. I am very pleased to be part of this event, Kantarlur Shala Lecture Series Program. As we know, Kantarlur Shala trying to represent the different view of thinking and approach to Vedic tradition. It is a fantastic moment of us. Today is the 5th lecture by Dr. K. A. Ravindran sir on Vedic exegesis, Kerala's contribution. All of we have noticed the academic excellence of Dr. K. A. Ravindran sir. He is my teacher, and also I have a personal relations with him. He has wrote most of 30 books, and most of them have Vedic tradition and Kerala tradition also. Now I am going to do my duty. First of all, my sincere thanks to the chair of the session. He has also presented a good introductory speech, Professor B. Simarli Madhavan sir. He is my beloved teacher and director and chief of Kandalur Shala. It is my immense pleasure to thanks to Dr. K. Ravindran sir for a wonderful presentation on behalf of Kandalur Shala. I also thank to Dr. Pradeep Jyothi sir and other authoritarians, colleagues, teachers and students. Once again, I thanks to all. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Shamsir.
Thank you, Shamsir. So we are concluding the session with the Shanti Patha.
I think
Sairadai Karne Bhishrunuya Madeva Bhadram Pashye Makshabhirya Jatraha Sthirairangai Stushtuvam Sastanobhir Vyashema Devahitan Yadayuhu Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. So this program is over. Thank you all.
Thank you one and all.
Thank you.
Let us join on 13th Monday at 6 p.m. Indian Standard Time for our Narayaniyam Fest. Thank you.
Thank you.